I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Enter. I think I'm through with that. My friend, I wish you a Merry Christmas and of course a Happy New Year. Maybe I will not get time to tell you that, but at least I have wished you a Merry Christmas. Hi there, this is Kazungu Duncan from Aero Productions, and today I'm going to show you how to create a splatter or dripping effect in Photoshop. So the first thing to do is to take a good photo of yourself, or if you do not want to use your photo, go on Google and search for a good photo the way I did and come and you work with it. And in case you want to download this image and follow along, please find a link in the description and download so that you can follow along. Now back in the magical world of Photoshop, the first thing to do is you have to remove your subject from the background. And of course, I've already masked out my subject, and I've just, you know, I didn't want to keep you here. So if I show you, that was before, then this is after I've, you know, masked her out. And you can see I have another layer here for hair, because when I masked her out, I realized that the hair was not looking that fine. So first of all, I, you know, refined the edges, of course, on the hair. Then after I did that, I had now a different layer where I painted hair, and I used a brush from Pixie Imperfect. I cannot remember when exactly I downloaded this, and maybe I will ask Unmesh to give me that link so that I can, you know, share with you. But this was a good brush, and thank you so much to Pixie Imperfect for offering this brush for free. So I painted that hair, and that's a good thing because I needed my subject at least to have hair. So if I can just zoom in and, you know, just put off the hair, you can see I just painted a little of it so that it creates that good thing. So after that, after you've removed your subject, now the design starts. So first of all, we shall create a new document, and to do that, come to File, then New. Just allow it to load. We can name it, what should we name it? Maybe Dripping, something like that. It's not something fancy. Then I can leave the dimensions to be HD. You can even use full HD, but for this tutorial, allow me to use this and just hit OK. So I'll have my document here. And the first thing I want to do on this document, I want to give it a gradient, right? So first of all, I will unlock my background by just clicking on this padlock. Now my background is unlocked. And then I'll double click on the right hand side of this layer so that I open up the blend if options, and here they are. Then when I'm here, I will now want to check the gradient overlay. Just check it so that it gives you the default, you know, gradient. You can use this default, but depending on the cloth of your subject or yourself, then you will want to use a color that matches with that. So I will come here and just pick, for example, I will come and click here once, and then I will pick a color. So I'll just click here on the shadows and click once here so that I can load a color, and then I can pick a yellow color. I think yellow will do me fine. Something with yellow or orange will work. So I'll just hit OK, and just I'll leave the highlights to have the white or the 50% gray. I think I like that. So I have that. So you will leave the angle at 90. Then you will make sure that align with the layer is checked, and then reverse should also be checked. And then the scale, by default it will be 100, but make sure that it is 150. Then just leave the things the way they are, and I think I like that, and just hit OK. Now that we have our background set, we can now bring in our subject and start working on her. So I will come to this layer, and then I don't want this white fill. I just put it there to direct me. So I'll just pick the first layer and then hold control and click on the second layer so that both of them are selected. Then I will drag them and place them on this my canvas, just like that. Then it is too big, so I'll have to zoom out just like that, and I will have to resize them from the corners. Hold shift and alt so that it is perfect. Control 0 to fit this to the screen. Then I will place us somewhere like that. I will also try to reduce just like that so that I can have a full picture of her. And I think I'll place her there, then hit enter or return. So she looks like that. I have her there. I have also this layer for hair. At least I have everything in this. We need now to have a dripping effect. So I had created this earlier. So I'll just go and bring it. I'll come to file and say place embedded. Then just allow it to load. Then I will come to, I think it was in D, then in a folder called PS, and then I'll come here and just come to, you know, this and select, where is it? I think I called it drip, just like that, and place it. And then I will want to resize this, so just hit enter, and then I will, first of all, I'll just make sure that it is not seen, because I realized that this, my subject is so dull, so I just needed to, you know, make sure that she is looking fine. So what I'll do, I'll now want to at least make her look beautiful. She is beautiful, but I just want to make her pop, right? So I'll come here on this adjustment layers and select curves. Just want to start with curves, and then I can, you know, bring this down a little bit so that it brings in that mood, just like that. And then I'll collapse this. I'll come back to here and pick something like exposure. I'm just doing the basics. I don't want to do, too much of it. Just want to make it a bit beautiful, not too much. So maybe something like that. Then the thing I want to do is I want to clip this on this very subject so that it does not affect the background. So I'll just come here and, you know, once I am on this line that separates the refined and the curve, I'll hold alt, then click to clip that. I'll also come here, hold alt, sorry, control Z, come here, hold alt and click so that they are clipped to this very line. So if I just turn this off, it doesn't look good. It now looks good. Then I'll come back to adjustment layers and select vibrance. And then on the vibrance, I'll also clip it by clicking this icon here. And then I will increase the vibrance. I usually don't do more than 50. So maybe I should do something like 32. It's okay. Then I will slightly increase the saturation to something like 14. Just like that. And I think it's now brought to life. If I say Control 0, you can now see it is now beautiful. Then I want to recommend to you some websites which will help you, especially to those of us who are growing. And these websites are providing free stuff that you can download. This video is sponsored with nobody. I just like these websites because they are offering free of charge, and this is something that you can depend on. So like, for example, the background music that you are hearing from this very tutorial is from mixkit.co. So if you visit their website mixkit.co, you will have access to free sound effects or background music. You can also get access to templates, both Adobe Creative Cloud, if you're using Illustrator, After Effects, Premiere Pro, they all have this. So if you're considering to find such things, visit mixkit.co. And if you've been so very much keen, I have made a slight change on my intro, right? So this intro, I got it from Top Free Intro adobeafterworld.com. This is a website that provides Adobe After Effects free templates. So I got this template from there, and of course I edited it. And the last website I want to recommend is canva.com. If you watch this video to the end, I have changed my outro. So I got this outro from canva.com and I just edited it and it suits me, and this is all for free. So in case you want these very services for free, I will have the links in the description of this video. You can go visit these awesome websites and I promise you, you will get something that you want. Back to our tutorial. Now I will now want to put this on, now that my very, you know, subject is now well, but if you look at it, it is too big, so I will want to, you know, just make it small. And maybe when I'm making it, I should also wish you a Merry Christmas. I know Christmas is 1 week away and most of us will be happy to have it. Now let me resize this, and I think I'll be so quick. Come now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today. Mary's child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Come now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today. Mary's child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. I wish you a Merry Christmas, I wish you a Merry Christmas, wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Enter. I think I'm through with that. My friend, I wish you a Merry Christmas and of course a Happy New Year. Maybe I will not get time to tell you that, but at least I have wished you a Merry Christmas. The next thing to do is now to, I want to make this as one layer, right? Just, I call it subject, right? So I'll just select this, select the first layer, that is vibrance, and then select the last, which is hair, and hit shift. Of course, it will select both of them, right click and say merge layers. So that is one layer. Then I'll double click here and just call it subject. Just name it to be good, just like that. So I'll come to drip, and when I'm here, and when I'm on this very icon, I'll just hold control and click. Once you do that, you'll find that it turns that into a selection. Then I will come to my subject and hit backspace or delete. When I do that, I'll have this well done, just like that. If I can zoom out, you can see it is well done. Then I'll just put this off. I am through with it. So I think I have my, you know, drip effect. So I'll come and remove this lower side by just picking the marquee tool and just making a selection here and hitting backspace. Make sure that the subject is select and hit backspace, control D to deselect, and I have my drip effect. Look at that, it looks so much beautiful. Then I'll just make sure that it is well, you know, placed. I just want to make it a little bit big, just like that. I think that's fine. Then I will also want to reposition it to somewhere like there. That's fine. Hit enter to accept the changes. Now we shall make a little, you know, changes to this so that it just looks beautiful, but so far I already like what I'm seeing. Now the next thing to do, I want to apply a drop shadow on this very, very subject. So I'll come to subject, then I'll come to FX, then I'll select drop shadow, just like that. Then this will load, of course. So I can just place this somewhere here, make it a bit small, just like that. I'll place this here. I just need also you see what is happening. So you may not see it, but then I'll explain what I'm doing. So when you are in this drop shadow, what you want to do or what you want to change is basically the distance, the spread, and the size. The color, just leave it as default, just leave it black. The blend mode, you can choose normal or linear light, still works the same, but I'll go for normal just to make it as simple as possible. Then the distance is how far should it be displaced, right? So I'll choose something like 5. I think 5 is okay. Sorry, I just hit enter, but don't worry, just double click on this drop shadow and it will bring back the effects. So I chose 5. Then on the spread, I'll also leave it at 5, because 5 it's fine for me. I think I like 5. If I just zoom in so that you see that effect. So if I remove it, that is how it is before. Then if I add it, that is how it is after. So the size, you can play around with the size, but I don't want a huge size. So I'll leave it at 4 or just leave it at 5, just like that. So that I keep everything constant, just leave 5, 5, 5. That one will work for you. Just leave this the way it is. Then the angle, just leave it at 90. But if you need it to be displaced to another angle, you are free to change this. But for this tutorial, I'll just leave it as 90. Then once that is done, I will just hit OK to accept the changes. So let me just zoom in and see how this looks like. If I put off the effects, that is how it looks like before the drop shadow. Then this is after the drop shadow. And I think I like that very drop shadow. So that is beautiful. Then I just want now to bring in the splatter effect. Of course, now you will need to download a splatter brush, which you are going to use in this very tutorial. And to get this, you can get it on brushizy.com. This is also a website that provides free brushes for Photoshop and even for Illustrator. So if you need some free brushes, please visit brushizy.com. I'll put a link in the description. So I'll come here, select this, my layer, just call this background. Let me just name it background, just to keep things tight and clean. Just call it background. Then I'll select the background and come to my, you know, how do you call it? To menu here. Then I'll just hit this to create a new layer. Then I'll just name this splatter to keep things good. And did I write it well? I don't know. Don't know if I wrote it well. Yeah. Anyway, just leave it to be splatter. Just write the right, what do you call it? Spelling. Yeah. So on this layer, when it is selected, now I'll come to pick my brushes. Just hit B on your keyboard and you'll get the brushes. So I installed these brushes. So after you've done that, you will want to install it. And you may ask me how to do that. Just select this top icon here. After you've selected the brush, come to this wheel, this setting wheel, and say import brushes. Then you will locate wherever you saved it and they will load. So this is the Pixie Imperfect brushes that I was talking about for hair. So I used this for hair, and I think Anmesh will give me a link. Then this is the splatter brushes, which I downloaded also from Brushizy. So I'll just come and I think I liked number 7. Let me see, not, was it 7 or? Yeah, it is this 7. So 7 was doing me fine, but then you'll find which does you fine. So I'll just resize the size of this very brush and just zoom in and make it a bit bigger. Just like that. Then when you have the brush on, if you hold Alt, it will change to an eyedropper. So you can hold Alt to change to an eyedropper and pick a color. So most probably I'll use a color that she's putting on. So I'll just hold Alt and then click to select the color. After you've selected, just release it and come to somewhere like here and paint, just like that. You can now change the angle at which this brush is by just coming here and changing it to somewhere like that, and just hit, for example, just like that to add something good, just like that. I can now pick a different brush, but still a how do you call it, a splatter. Then I'll just come here and resize this. After I've resized this, I'll also change the angle so that it looks something like, let me see, not really, let me change this to, yes, it's coming. Yeah, I think I like that. I'll collapse this, then I'll make it a bit big and just hit here, just like that. I can make another one here, and then I can also change the angle so that it looks this way. I think this will be fine. Then I'll come here and just click to create that splatter effect, just like that. So if I hit Control Zero, look at that. You can do some fancy things. You can find better splatter brushes. So I just downloaded this because I like them, but maybe you may want it to be more. For me, I don't like it, but for you, I'll just, you know, show you how to do that. But for me, it's not good for me, but I think it's something good you can try. I can just place this somewhere like that. So just find some good brushes from Brusheezy, and I think you will do your thing. Now, guys, I think this is fine. You can now put your logo, you can put your username for Instagram. For example, when I created this, I placed a username for, you know, for my Instagram, but I don't think that is relevant at this point. So the next thing I want just to do is I want to now create a camera raw. And this is where everything changes. This is where the magic happens. Wait, did I just tell my secret? Anyway, I've already said it, so I'll just do it. So I don't want this layer because I'm not using it at all. So let me just delete this, just like that. So once the top layer is selected, you will hit this combination, Shift, Control, Alt, E. This one combines the layer that are below into one layer. So it merges all of them. In short, it creates a stamp visible layer. Then we can rename this to something like Camera Pro, just to keep things nice. Then I will want to convert this to a smart object so that in case I make a mistake or in case I want to change, I'll come back and change this. And I'll just come to filter, then say convert for smart filters and hit OK. Then I'll come to filter, and now I will load the camera raw filter. So guys, I am sorry, the power has gone off, so you may not see the light. I'm really, really sorry. So once the camera raw has loaded, I'll now just come and make some little changes. We shall do it as fast as possible so that, you know, this light cannot affect us. So I'll just add in some warmth, then I will just give it some life by just slightly increasing the contrast. I'll come to this, my, you know, exposure, and just kill it a little bit, not too much. Then I'll come to the highlights. I'll try to increase the highlights so that it brings that life. The shadows, I'll also increase the shadows so that they are not dark. The whites, I'll also do this. Or if I just leave it as zero, then I'll come here on the whites, hold shift and double click so that it loads and it will place it wherever it should place it by default. Then after that has been done, I'll come to the blacks, hold shift, double click, then it will automatically load and place it to where it deserves to be. So Photoshop will do that for me. Then for the textures, I'll add a little bit of the textures. I usually don't like adding more of it because it makes it look not fine. The clarity, I'll also slightly increase the clarity, just like that. Then the vibrance, I'll also increase the vibrance. Not saturation. I don't like increasing saturation. I need this to increase. And I said I don't usually do more than 50, but for this, I will just do something like 10. The light is coming and going and all that, so please understand. So to see the before and after, I'll just hit here. So that was before, it was very flat, and this is after, and I like that. So I'll come to, let me come to effects, so that I can add some vignetting, so that I can have, you know, the focus on the subject. So I'll just drop this to somewhere like that, and I'll now start playing around with this to see how it affects. So I'll increase the midpoint, the roundness. I'll also just do like that, and I will come the feathering. I'll also increase the feathering just like that, so it fades away. Then I'll now come to amount and try to reduce it so that it is not that dark. So at least someone will be focused on my subject to see the before and after. That was before, and that is after. And I think I like the after. Once you are satisfied, you will now hit OK. And then Photoshop will apply that filter. And I guess this is something good. So this is before, and this is after. I am sure this is something good that you want to engage with. So guys, I felt like sharing with you today about how to create such art in Photoshop. And this I just created for fun, right? It's just for fun, but I know it has taught you something. So guys, in case you found value in this video, feel very, very free to subscribe. And not only subscribe, my friend, ring that bell so that you do not miss any future tips, tricks, or tutorials. You can also share this video to your friends so that they can also learn such things in Photoshop. And that being said, I hope I will see you in my next video.